It's hard to imagine what Australia would have looked like before all these cars, buildings, and goats. Yes, goats. But if you travel to an island just off the coast of Western Australia, you'll be transported 400 years back in time, before European contact and before goats. Bear with me, the whole goat thing will make sense a bit later on. This is Dirk Hartog Island. It's located about 850 k's north of Perth, right near Useless Loop. Oh, Useless Loop, I'm sure you're terribly useful. The island was named after this guy, Dirk Hartog. He was a Dutch sea captain who got a bit lost on his way to Southeast Asia and accidentally stumbled upon the island way back in 1616, hundreds of years before Captain Cook arrived. He spent about 3 days exploring, left a plaque, and quickly set off for Southeast Asia again. In the early 1900s, Dirk Hartog Island became home to a sheep station, complete with about 19,000 sheep. Then in 2009, it was declared a national park and listed as a World Heritage Site. Now it's home to something else, one of the world's largest restoration projects. The aim is to try to recreate the ecosystem that would have existed on this island before Mr. Hartog arrived.
When Dirk Hartog arrived on Dirk Hartog Island back in 1616, there was 13 species of ground-dwelling animals on the island. And since 150 years of pastoralism and feral introduction of cats onto the island, there's only three left.
The first step was to rid the island of the thousands of feral pests, including some goats. See? I told you. Goats. And after 4 years of effort, this month experts on the ground finally declared the island goat, sheep and cat free.
Removing the cats was the big outcome that we were seeking in the first stage of the project, because that then paves the way of being able to return the animals that were once there.
That brings us to step two. Now that the island is free of pests, it's time to start reintroducing some of the native species that once lived here. Last year, 12 rufous and 12 banded hair wallabies were taken from the nearby Byrne and Door Islands and placed onto Dirk Hartog. These little guys are both threatened species, but scientists on the island say they're doing really well in their new home, and there's a good chance their numbers will start to increase. In the coming years, other animals will be brought back onto the island, including eastern barred bandicoots, shark bay mice, woylies, dibblers, and shaddocks. And soon it will be really close to what it once was. And most importantly, no goats. Sorry, goats.
Okay, you were so close, come on! It's Loco and Subscribo.